Greetings and salutations, and welcome to my review of 2015's Patchwork. Before getting into the review, here are my ratings for this movie. I give the story 0.75 out of 2, the direction 1.25, the pace 0.75, the acting 1.25, and the enjoyment level 0.75. These give Patchwork a 4.75 out of 10. There are two bad things about the movie. The first is that they are calling it a horror. The second is the many links to Reanimator. These are intentional, as the director thanks Stuart Gordon in the credits. It wouldn't have been so bad if the correlations weren't there to sell the film. It's good to pay homage, but do it more subtly. I was okay with the glowing green Reanimator fluid, which was understated in its appearance. However, the more prominent character of the surgeon is in your face. He is loud, brash, and completely ignorant, and an idiot to boot. But you can see Herbert West just under the skin. Regrettably, the actor Corey Sorensen is not Jeffrey Coons, and the surgeon is not Herbert West. The writer, Chris Lee Hill, along with the director, Tyler McIntyre, should have created their own character here. Somebody more believable and less the village fool. The story goes a step further than Reanimator in the respect that science can now recreate people as they wish, by using spare body parts. And, with the reanimation agent, there's no longer any time limit to how long a limb can last, or even if it comes from a cadaver. So, shades of Frankenhooker here, though Frank Nenlotter doesn't receive a thank you. And, Patchwork does work like and look like an up-to-date Frankenhooker. It's here the story gets too clever for its own good. It would appear that the flesh holds the soul and the memories and the feelings of the owner, and not the brain. Because when the three ladies get stitched together, each of their psyches and personas remains. So now the host body has two more people to contend with. Oh, the joys of hearing these women bitch, whine, and moan about their lives. This bellyaching becomes nerve-grating fast. And, for me, it lost all the humor it possessed. These segments needed to be wittier and funnier. Maybe the writers should have gone down to their local comedy club and asked an expert for help. Though looking at the trash the movie industry calls human nowadays, all this film needed were more severed penises. There's one guy who enjoys his food. But, wait, what's that in his hot dog? It doesn't look like a sausage to me. Don't get me wrong, there are some humorous moments throughout the film, but not many. The slapstick comedy segments suffer from timing and direction issues, both of which needed reviewing and tightening. I do have to give McIntyre credit, as there are a few scenes that work brilliantly. The first time we realize that Patchwork is three people and not one is a brilliant, well-thought-out segue, and it's carried out in a blink of an eye. Patchwork enters her house and walks through the door into her kitchen and finds her two new personas waiting. This is a fluid transition that you may not even notice. But it is great in its simplicity and effect. The special effects are haphazard. Sometimes the fake limbs are too floppy, and you wonder if the team had forgotten to slip the bone in, to give it stability. Then you have the great effects of the stitched face. When we first see Patchwork, you can differentiate between her skin doneness. Each lady has different skin tones and textures. The reveal in the mirror is shocking and beautiful. I loved this scene and effect. It's a pity that in the later scenes you know the actress is wearing a second-rate mask. The women's skin tones and textures vanish. The acting is above average, though I would have preferred one of the other actresses to take the lead as Jennifer. Both possess better acting skills and on-screen presence. Especially, Tracy Faraway, who plays Elle. Elle is the only character who has depth. And I believe most of her richness is due to Faraway. Even Corey Sorensen isn't too bad. It's a shame they took the character in the direction they did. I would have liked to have seen what he could have done with a better role. Patchwork is more dark fantasy than a horror. And, I can't bring myself to call it a comedy, either. So if you like dark fantasies about stitched-up women with some humor thrown in, then this may be for you. I can say I'll not watch this again. I'll stick with the original Gordon films as they are all superior. The film did make me laugh, and that's always good. And I'm glad I saw Patchwork's crazy stitched face, which will stay with me for a while. Take care and stay well.